Hey, it's one of these videos again. some updates. I'm back on Patreon. After 8 days, yesterday they finally got me back on, and they told me there was some kind of internal problem. Apparently something got messed up on their end and locked me out. It was something to do with their data distribution network that they have set up, and but they said that as a result of the problem they had with me, they said it was very, very unusual issue. But as a result of my being locked out, they've changed how their platform handles traffic, and so they said that it should never happen again to anybody. So I guess I took one for the team. But I'm back on Patreon, and so I was able to thank the hundreds of new patrons. Spent most of the day yesterday on Patreon thanking everybody. and also, this morning, they started demolition in my building. Yay! I've been thinking about how to deal with this because I didn't have time to move out before they started demolishing, and I've heard them bashing down walls on behind my apartment all morning. But I have a solution, at least I'm trying a solution, for the dust, to keep the dust out of my apartment. So I've turned my ventilation system around 180 degrees, and I've created a positive pressure system. In fact, it is a HEPA-filtered positive pressure system to pressurize my apartment above the outside pressure so that dust from the adjacent apartments won't come in as a result of the breeze and draft and pushing the air out through the cracks in my apartment rather than letting stuff come through those cracks. So it's positive pressure, HEPA-filtered positive pressure. So I'm hoping this will keep the dust at bay. I've used something like this before, and one of the curious things about positive pressure, because I've got several HEPA filters in my apartment, and when I moved to Philly and started filtering the air, the one thing that I found was this weird gray dust, and I thought it was coming from my apartment, but after I had been hooked up my ventilation system, which is just drawing air directly from outside from the flue, which is just bringing air down the flue rather than putting it up, this is outside air, fresh air, and finding on my pre-filters the same matted gray dust. In fact, let me show you. This is the pre-filter from my outside ventilation system. This is air pollution from outside. This isn't inside dust. This is from outside. See that thick gray mat? This puzzled me. This is about 2 or 3 weeks worth of air pollution just trapped in the pre-filter. So this is actually just the large particles. It's not even like the nano-sized particles. This is like not even just barely the HEPA-sized particles, just coming from outside. You can see some of the bugs and stuff that came down the flue too. But this is the air, just the concentrated air pollution from the air. You see, that's the back side of the filter. That's the front side. Yeah, when I first saw the HEPA pre-filters having this gray dust, I thought it was something unique to this building or the air pollution in this area. But when I did the video with Scott Kipp, and he was showing me the inside of the Wanamaker organ, the time that he took apart a wind chest that he had just re-gasketed about 6 months previous with this white leather gasket, and when we pulled the wind chest open, he pointed out that these gaskets, I replaced this one just 6 months ago, and look at the filth from the outside air being forced through the big turbines to pressurize the organ, that the same gray dust was being forced through the organ, and they had to clean it out every now and then. So it wasn't just unique to my neighborhood, it's all over Philadelphia. And I've never had it analyzed, but if you pinch it and put it between your fingers, it's very silty. It feels almost like graphite dust. So it's a very, very fine, probably round particles. I imagine it's very, very finely granulated silica. Philadelphia has a lot of demolition, and it's a lot of cement roads, and also, of course, the highways that are, there's 95 on this side, and Vine Street are all cement. So I figured that with the traffic on the cement roadways and plus all the demolition in Philadelphia, that it was just this very fine silica that had been just filtered by the air, sort of as the air goes through all the buildings and stuff. The vortices and such basically act like a big Dyson vacuum and just filter the air just so that the very finest particles stay airborne, and that's what is just in the air all the time. So yeah, air pollution. But let me show you the the system I built. This is my ventilator, and basically what I did today is I unbolted it and I flipped it around 180 degrees so that the output is actually on this side instead of going towards the flue. The flue's right there, and so I have it flipped around so it's drawing air from outside, pressurizing it here, and then coming around here to this HEPA filter, and it's forcing the air in. This is the pre-filter here, which I change out every couple weeks, and it's really blasting out of this HEPA filter. So I mean, when you got the air pressurized going in, the blower motor doesn't have to work at all, so it's just blowing through the HEPA filter. So you know, it's my stopgap solution to keeping the dust out. So yep. And I have a motor speed control so that I can just keep the speed down. If I run this full blast, it would just overwhelm the HEPA filter and it would be just bringing cold air in, too much cold air. But I basically just have it pressurized to the point where it's just keeping the smell and junk from the adjacent apartments out. You can hear the demolition. So I imagine this will be going on for some time, so I'll probably have to keep this running most days until they're done, however long that is. It could be all month. But I'm pretty confident in this. Let me show you some of my concern, though. Okay, so we're up here in the beams. These are actually the beams. This is, like I said, this was originally a former ink factory, but I'm up, the rafters are all open in the building. And for 20 years, this was a brake relining factory. In fact, my neighbor who just passed away a few months ago, Leo Razzi, he made art with all of the brake pads that were left in this building when they repurposed it into an apartment building. I'll post some pictures of that. But this is the stuff that worries me. All this, see all the stuff trapped in the paint? And this thing here. See all that? You can see the fibers. That's basically like a mat of fibrous junk with a coat of paint on it. Who knows exactly what it is? You can see the fibers sticking out that have been painted over. And the beams are basically covered in this basically painted over fibrous junk, and you know, I would assume that with decades relining truck drum brakes, that a good portion of that, or at least some of that fibrous gunk, is probably asbestos. So that's the stuff I really don't want kicked up. But anyway, enough of my yapping. I got stuff to do. So I'm not really sure. I looked at this new space. I put it to the property owner. It's up to them if they want to relocate, if they want me out of the building early. But I mean, they're doing the demolition, so if this positive pressure system works, if they're done the demolition in a few weeks or a month or whatever, I might have to stick out the winter before I relocate the lab. I'd prefer not to move in the winter if I didn't have to. I would just have to see how it goes. If they make a deal to relocate me, then I'll tear up everything and relocate, this upcoming month maybe. But if not, then I'll be sticking it out until March. Wait until the winter weather breaks to find a new place. But sooner or later, all this will be gone. I'm still moving the stuff to storage so that it'll be ready to move if need be, sooner or slightly later. But it's going to happen sometime in the next few months, or 6 months. Demolition time. Thanks.